B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to see a step-by-step complete build of how to make an Arduino robot car with an ultrasonic distance sensor device for hands-free operation. It doesn't matter whether you've ever used Arduino before or built a robot car before, this video is going to show you from start to finish where to buy the components, all the way to and including the programming code that you need to put into your Arduino IDE just to get your robot to move. From there, you can adjust it however you want. Let's get started. Here are the components that you'll need for this build. You'll need the L293D DC motor drive shield. You'll need the Arduino Uno or the Mega. Either one's fine. I use the Uno. You'll need the SG90 micro server motor. The HC-SR04 ultrasonic sensor, a mini breadboard, a 9-volt battery clip attachment, male-to-male and female-to-female jumper wires. I only use one male-to-male jumper wire, and then I use four of the female-to-female jumper wires for the ultrasonic sensor. And I'm using the DIY robot smart car chassis kit that I reviewed previously. I won't be using the battery pack that you see in the picture, but I will be using a 9-volt battery instead. And you'll need some male pin headers. And that's it. Well, here's the star of the show here, the L293D motor driver shield. And you'll notice that there are some chips up here on the top. The chips on either side here are the L293D driver chips. And that means that we have two here, and that means that we can independently power four DC motors, two on either side. The chip in the middle is a 595 shift register, and that adds four digital pins to the eight directional pins for either chip. So that's a little bit about the chipsets up here on top. There's a couple different ways that you can power this, and it's important to know. So this yellow jumper pack right here, that is the power supply selection jumper. And you can leave that on as long as you supply less than 12 volts of power, either through the shield, like I'm doing. I'm using 9 volts power applied right here at the shield. Or if you use the 9 volt battery through the barrel jack down here at the Arduino. But if you use both power through the Arduino and through the shield, you want to remove that jumper pack, otherwise your boards will overheat and you don't want that. Now I'm powering everything through a 9-volt battery right here attached to the shield. That's fine for what I'm doing because I'm using two 3-to-6-volt DC motors and then just a simple, really cheap and low-duty servo motor. So it's not a big deal. If I were using more motors or bigger motors, I may want to separate the power for the motors from the Arduino so that you don't stress out your Arduino or overheat it. And in that case, I would supply power to the Arduino and the shield and remove that jumper. So it's important whether or not you keep that jumper there in place. So keep that in mind. And just a little bit about the board. Some of the stuff we've already mentioned. It can drive four DC motors with speed and direction. And here you have the black and white, the positive and negative ports of each motor. And in between those, the green arrow on either side is the ground port. And you can also drive two stepper motors, one stepper motor on each side that uses the M1, M2 ports, and then the M3 and M4 ports. And you can also drive two servo motors, servo 1 and servo 2 up there at the top left of the board. And down here at the bottom, you have a 4.5 to 25 volt range on the external power here. And it has a 1.2 amp peak current per channel. So you can get a lot of power out of this little board. And some other things worth mentioning is that the servo 1 is operated on D10, the D10 pin, and servo 2 is operated on the D9 pin of your Arduino board. And this is just the location of motor 1, motor 2, motor 3, and motor 4, as indicated by the M1 through M4 on the board there. And down here you can solder in your pin headers, which will do 6 pin headers for 5 volt for Arduino. You can solder in below that 6 pin headers for ground, and then below that 6-pin headers for A0 through 5, which come in very handy, and we'll do that here in just a minute. Here's the jumper sleeve, or the jumper pack for the external power that I mentioned just a while ago. And then here is the Arduino board reset button. So before we do anything else, we're going to go ahead and solder some pin headers in the 5 volt ground and A0 to A5 pinhole rows that we just looked at on the driver board. So get you a length of 6 male pin headers and solder those in there. That way, instead of soldering a permanent wire in there, you can make your connections with male to female or female to female jumper wires. It'd be much easier. Well, we're done soldering. I got those 3 rows of pin headers soldered on here. And by the way, I use a 0.8 millimeter 6337 tin lead rosin core solder wire with a fine tip on my soldering iron. So it's far from perfect, but it'll work for what we're going to do today. Now it's time to hot glue the base of this servo motor onto the front of the chassis. And the reason I'm doing that is because I can easily remove it if I want to use this chassis for something different in the future. And on top of this servo motor will be the arm of the servo motor, and that will hold the ultrasonic sensor. As you can see, I glued the arm of the servo motor onto the top of my ultrasonic sensor. I won't be using the screw for that servo arm into the servo, just because I didn't know if I'd need access to it. I wanted to be able to remove it if I needed to. If you do it this way, just know that it can fall off, but it has worked well for me. It is pretty sturdy. You probably noticed I did mount my ultrasonic sensor upside down, and I did that so that it can move freely as the wires are connected. So when it's time to mount your expansion board on top of your Uno, just line up your digital pins and your analog pins and then press it together. Well, I wanted to include how I connected everything together, but I didn't want to bore you with every slow detail. What I'm going to do is do kind of like a chalkboard type thing here so that you can see more clearly the connections. You guys let me know what you think. I've never done it before. It does take longer to put together, but if you like it, I'll use it again. Here we go. Got it all put together, flip the switch, and it works. Pretty happy with it so far. Here's a quick look at the top of it, and then the sides where the motors are attached. And you'll find it pretty easy to put together, not too bad. The next thing we're going to do is open Arduino IDE, and you need to include these 3 libraries. So the first thing we'll do is go up here to Tools, go to Manage Libraries, and it will pull up this menu, and you go up here and type in Adafruit for AF motor. Whoops, change my window. And then you've got, this is the one you want, the Adafruit Motor Shield version 2 library. I do have both of them, but this is the version 2. It's the newer one. So you want to install that. You also need NewPing. Just type in NewPing, and you see that right here. All right, and you want to install that one. Now you should have Servo, but if you don't, just type in Servo, and then install that one as well. And after you install that, close that out. After we install our libraries, go up here to Tools, and select your board. I use the Uno in the video, But right now I have the Mega attached to the computer, so I will select, take it off the Uno, and I will select the Mega. And then you want to come up here and make sure that you have the right port. And for me, it's COM4. And if this doesn't show up, unplug your USB cord, plug it into another USB, and then you'll be able to select it. So I'm going to select COM4. And we also define the trig pin, the echo pin, at analog 0 and analog 1. And we have a max distance of 200 that it'll travel, the robot will travel before looking around with the ultrasonic sensor. Now you can change your max speed. If 150 is too fast or too slow, you can go up or down with that. Now down here we set up the ultrasonic sensor with the new ping library, and we set up the two motors 1 and 2 with the AF motor library, and of course we set up the servo, we name our servo with the servo library, and then we come down here and we come down here to setup, and remember we attached the servo at digital pin 9, the other option was 10, and then down here is the loop. And I will have this posted, so just check the description for that. And then I come up here, COM4, Mega, and then so after I've included all of my programming code, I can upload to my board. And right now it's uploading to my Mega board. So if you're using Uno, it would upload to your Uno board. So here we are with the final product, and sometimes if he doesn't have enough space in front of him, he will tap a wall or tap an object in front of him. You'll see here in just a second. Your robot may also slide along an object or scrape along an object and not even detect it because it's outside of the periphery of the ultrasonic sensor, and you may be able to adjust that by going into the code and changing the angle that the servo motor uses when the ultrasonic sensor is looking around. Overall, this is a pretty fun project. It's always fun to learn about new expansion boards, and I hope you guys feel the same way about it whenever you all build yours. Well, that's all I've got for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you again very soon.